Hello and welcome to the course on design of machine elements 2. So today we will see unit number 6, which is on design of sliding rod bearings. I am Dr. L.S. Dhamande. We are going to cover the following contents during this presentation. Classification of sliding rod bearing will be seen first. Then we'll talk about the lubricating oils, their properties, different additives, then selection of lubricating oils, then properties and selection of bearing materials. After that, we'll see the hydrodynamic lubrication, theory of hydrodynamic lubrication, pressure development in oil film. Then we'll see the two-dimensional basic Reynolds equation. So in that, few terms are there like Sommerfeld number. Then there is one method who Raimondi and Boyd have developed for solving the Reynolds equation of a hydrodynamic bearing. So that method is based on experimentation. So we will see that method in which you are going to make use of different tables and charts to solve the problem of bearing design. Then there will be thermal considerations, and after that we will see the different parameters in bearing design, such as length diameter ratio, unit bearing pressure, radial clearance, minimum oil film thickness, etc. So at the end of this course, as it is unit number 6, so we are writing it as a CO6. At the end of this course, the students will be able to achieve an expertise in the design of sliding contact bearings for industrial applications. So we know that bearing is actually supporting the shaft. So this is nothing but the shaft, this is a bearing, and there is a lubricating oil being present between the bearing and the shaft. This shaft is also called as journal. So this D indicates the shaft diameter, small d, and the capital D indicates the bearing diameter. So there is a eccentricity between these two centers of shaft and the center of the bearing, which is indicated by E. This is the minimum oil film thickness which will be maintained between the shaft and the bearing, and the shaft is rotating with n rpm. So first we will see the bearings. So bearings are machine elements which are used to support a rotating member, that is shaft. Then it is used to transmit the load from a rotating member to a stationary member, which is known as the frame or the housing, and it permits relative motion of the two members in one or two directions with minimum friction. And also it is used to prevent the motion in the direction of the applied load. So based on the type of contact they have between the rotating and the sliding stationary member, there are two different types of bearings basically. So one is sliding contact bearing and another is a rolling contact bearing. So first we will see initially here what are the different advantages that we are getting over the rolling contact bearings, because we have already studied the rolling contact bearings before in unit number 3. So the design of bearing and housing is simple here. Then they occupy less space, that is the less radial space, and are more compact compared to the rolling rod bearing. Because in case of rolling rod bearing, this shaft is required to be mounted over the inner race. There is a ball or roller in between the inner race and the outer race of a ball bearing, and this outer race will be mounted over the housing. So in this case, that inner race, outer race, ball, that particular parts are not there. There is the direct journal and this bearing. In between these two, there is a lubricating oil. So definitely the radial space is less occupied, and therefore the cost of this bearing is also less. The design of the shaft is simple in this case, and they operate more silently. There is smooth motion, and because of which there is less noise will be generated. So they are having a good shock load carrying capacity, and they are ideally suited for medium and high speed operations. So definitely there will be some disadvantages also with this kind of bearing. So first is that as there is a sliding contact between the journal and the bearing through the lubricating oil, actually there is a contact between the journal and the lubricating oil, and the oil and the bearing. So frictional losses are more in this case, which is not there in case of ball bearing, because generally even ball bearing is called as a anti-friction bearing because there is a point contact. So they are they required good attention to lubrication, that is the disadvantage of this, and they are normally designed to carry radial load or axial load only separately, while in case of ball bearings or roller bearings, taper roller bearings, they can carry axial as well as radial loads both simultaneously. Now depending on the sliding rod at this classification of the sliding rod bearings can be made based on the type of load carried, based on the type of lubrication, and based on lubrication mechanism. So before we see into the details of those bearings, we will see what is the lubrication and what are the modes of this lubrication. So lubrication is the science of reducing friction by application of suitable substance called lubricant between the rubbing surfaces of bodies having relative motion. So lubricants are of three types, or you can say that they can be categorized into a liquid form of a bearing, a lubricant, a semi-solid lubricant, and solid lubricant. So liquid lubricant can be a mineral oil or vegetable oil, while generally semi-solid lubricant is nothing but we are already aware of a grease we are using, and the solid lubricant can be a graphite or molybdenum disulfide. So the basic objective of lubrication is to reduce the friction as well as minimize the wear and carry away the heat, because there will be heat generated when there is a motion, relative motion between the two components, and there is sliding contact, so friction will be there, and that friction will increase the temperature, that is heat. So this heat is to be carried away, and for carrying away this heat, lubricant is used, and also it is going to protect the system from the corrosion. So what are the expected properties from a good lubricant? So the good lubricant should give rise to low friction. It should adhere to the surface and reduce the wear. It should protect the system from corrosion. Also, it should have good cleaning effect on the surface. At the same time, it should carry away as much heat from the surface as possible. It should have a thermal and oxidation stability, and also it should have a good thermal durability also. At the same time, it should have anti-foaming ability, because it should not form the foams, and it should be compatible with the seal materials, because whatever the material is used for sealing purpose, so there should not be any kind of chemical reaction that will take place between the seal and the lubricating oil, and it will deteriorate the seals. So accordingly, it is required that it should be compatible with the seal materials, and it should be cheap and available in plenty. So that is the requirement of lubricating oil. So now we will see how these lubricating oils are specified. So just take an example, like there is one grading made by SAE, Society of Automotive Engineers. So they are specifying the grades like SAE 20, 30, 40, like this. So if any oil is specified like SAE 30, so this oil will lie between the thickest oil, that is SAE 20, and the thinnest oil, SAE 40. So in between that, it is having certain viscosity. So SAE 20, 30, 40, so many numbers that it is being specified. So they all are specified at 100 degrees Celsius. Sometimes SAE 5W or SAE 10W and SAE 20W, like this, some oils are specified. So these oils are at, means generally it is W is for the winter. So it is used, it is specified at minus 18 degrees Celsius. So SAE, sometimes SAE 10W40 oil may be specified. So it means it is the 10W viscosity requirement will be satisfied at minus 18 degrees Celsius, and 40 requirement will be at 100 degrees Celsius, like this. So ISO specification of lubricating oils. So industrial fluid lubricants are commonly specified in terms of international standards. Now these standards like ASTM D2422, so another is American National Standard Z11.232 and ISO Standard 3448. So ISO specification of lubrication oils The viscosity grades are designated as ISO VG followed by number equal to the nominal kinematic viscosity at 40 degrees Celsius. So ISO VG grades are also there, and generally they are specified at 40 degrees Celsius. So 18 grades are specified with kinematic viscosity at 40 degrees Celsius. So these different 18 grades are like 3, 5, 7, 10, 15, 22, 46, 468, 100, 150, 220, 320, 460, 680, 1000 and 6000 centistokes, that is meters mm square per second. Now we will see some of the recommended oils for a particular application. So SE10, this oil is used for spindle oil for light loaded bearings and high speeds, while SE20-40, these oils are used for as a machine oil for bearings of IC engines, machine tools and turbines, etc. While SE40-50, this means 40 and 50, this range is used for diesel engines, heavy load and medium speeds machine oil. While SE60-70, this machine oil for temperature, heavy load and low speeds. So mostly it is for high temperature, heavy load and low speeds. Now we'll talk about the bearing materials. So bearing materials significance is that generally it is at the start of the hydrodynamic lubrication. So when there is a metal to metal contact occurs, or during mixed and boundary lubrication period, and at stop. So most commonly used bearing materials are babbitts. Other materials such as tin bronze, leaded bronze, copper lead alloy, aluminum bronze, cast iron and aluminium alloys are used in many applications. So typical composition of bearing materials are given below. One is tin based babbitts with 89% SN, 8% PB and 3% CU. Then lead based babbitts with 75% PB, 15% SB and 10% SN. And third, copper alloys such as CU 10% and 15%, means 10% to 15% PB, like that. So now these are the different desirable properties of a good bearing material. First is conformability. It is low elastic modulus. It means deformability. Conformability and deformability. So conformability is talking about the low elastic modulus, and deformability is talking about plastic flow. To relieve local high pressures caused by misalignment and shaft deflection. This is important. Now second is embeddability or indentation softness. It is used to permit small foreign particles to become safely embedded in the material, thus protecting the journal against wear. Now third is the low shear strength. It is for easy smoothing of surface asperities. Now fourth is adequate compressive strength and fatigue strength for supporting the load and for enduring the cyclic loading as with engine bearings under all operating conditions. Then good thermal conductivity to dissipate the frictional heat, and coefficient of thermal expansion similar to the journal and housing material. The next is the compatibility with a journal material to resist scoring, welding and seizing. And the seventh is the good corrosion resistance against the lubricant and engine. So up till now we have seen different materials used, different lubricants and their properties and their standards. So now we will talk about the modes of lubrication. So basically there are three modes of lubrication. One is called as thick film lubrication, another is thin film lubrication, and third is zero film lubrication. So thick film lubrication, in this case the two surfaces of the bearing in relative motion are completely separated by the film of fluid, and there is no contact between the surfaces, and therefore the surface properties are not at all important in the thick film lubrication. But the viscosity of the lubricant is important parameter. So this lubricant viscosity will affect the performance of that type of bearing. Second is a thin film bearing in which actually there is a boundary lubrication, and zero film means there is no film as such. So we are going to study here the thick film lubrication. Basically it is being divided into two types. One is a hydrostatic bearing and hydrodynamic bearing. So here we will see the bearing classification. So based on the type of load carried, one is the radial bearing, another is a thrust bearing or axial bearing, and the third is a radial thrust bearings. So second mode of classification is the type of lubrication. So just now we have discussed about the thick film lubrication, thin film lubrication, and the boundary lubrication. So what exactly mean by thick film lubrication? So you can see here there is a completely separation of the two components, you can see the shaft and the bearing. So it is having a thickness of lubricating oil from 8 to 20 microns, and the coefficient of friction is 0.02 to 0.01 in case of thick film lubrication, while in case of thin film lubrication the coefficient of friction is from 0.004 to 0.10, while in case of boundary lubrication the 0.05 to 0.2 is the range of coefficient of friction. So definitely you can see here there is a more gap, the gap goes on reducing because there may be some partial metal to metal contact, and here there is much more contact is there in case of boundary lubrication. So this thin film lubrication can be used in the applications like door hinges, machine slides. So here we can see radial bearing, shaft is there, and this bearing this particular shaft load will be transferred from this lubricating oil to this particular housing. So this is radial bearing because the load will be acting in the radial direction in this case. Now this is single collar thrust bearing. So in this case the force is applied in the axial direction along the axis of this bearing, and the pressure is being created over here between the bearing surface and the journal surface. While this is multiple collar thrust bearing, in this case you can have so many number of collars here like this, which is in this case you have single collar, this is number of collars. Now axial force applied over this in this bearing, and definitely the pressure will be created at all these surfaces. And this is radial thrust bearing. So in this case it is radial as well as thrust force. So you can see here this particular shaft is there, it is having this axial force towards right and this radial force downward. So this particular is the surface which is providing that radial force, and which is carrying this particular radial force, and this is the surface which is carrying the axial force. Okay, so now next is the bearing classification based on lubrication mechanism. So hydrodynamic lubricated bearings are there, then hydrostatic lubricated bearings are there, then elasto hydrodynamic lubricated bearings are there, boundary lubricated bearings are there, and solid film lubrication bearings are there. So we will see these one by one. So first we will see hydrodynamic lubricated bearings. So in this case you can see that just now we discussed about this journal. There is a bearing, this particular surface is the bearing, this is oil being present in between the journal and the bearing. And now the force which is acting over this journal is this one, and the resistive force developed in the bearing is this one. So as this journal rotates, this oil will be pushed downward, and because of that as it rotates you will find that there is a pressure being created over here at the bottom of this particular journal. So this is actually the pressure distribution core, and this pressure actually it is carrying the load offered by this particular bearing. So we are going to see in details of all this geometry in the next slides. So this is hydrostatic lubricated bearing. In this case there is no external pressurization is there, which is in this, and if it is called a hydrodynamic bearing, so because of its motion only, during rotation only, that pressure will be created in the oil, while in this case you are going to use externally pressurized lubricating oil, and it is being supplied to the bearing. So as you can see, the basic difference between these two bearings is that, so initially this particular bearing will be touching to the surface of the journal, means journal and bearing will be in contact, and once they rotate then it will be having separation of these two, while in this case the pressurized oil will be keeping this journal and the bearing always in separation. So you can see here this is a supply of oil which is given to this particular bearing bearing. So these particular bearings are generally used in vertical turbo generators, centrifuges, ball mills, etc. So now first of all we will discuss about the hydrostatic lubrication. So hydrostatic lubrication is defined as the system of lubrication in which the load supporting the fluid film separating the two surfaces is created by an external source like pump supplying sufficient fluid under pressure. So it is also called an externally pressurized bearing. So pressurized fluid is supplied to this particular journal. Now generally when the suppose you are not going to supply any fluid from the pump, so definitely that time this particular journal will be touching to this particular bearing surface. But before we start the rotation of that particular shaft, actually we are going to supply the oil under pressure to this pump, and therefore this particular shaft will get lifted and there is separation, complete separation of the shaft and the bearing. So these are generally used in vertical turbo generators, centrifuges and ball mills that we already discussed. So basic advantage of this kind of bearing is that it has a very high load carrying capacity even at low speeds, because in case of hydrodynamic bearings we need a particular speed. So after attaining only a particular speed, pressure development will be there in the fluid, but as you are going to supply the externally pressurized fluid to this particular type of bearing, so it doesn't need a high speed. So in a low speed also it can carry a very high load, and that high load carrying capacity depends upon the amount of pressure of the oil that you are supplying. And even you will find out that there is no starting friction as it is there in case of hydrodynamic bearing. So starting friction is not there in this. So initially before you start the rotation of the shaft, actually you are supplying the fluid to this particular bearing, and therefore this bearing will be lifted in position and then you are going to start it. So when it is starting, at that time there is no contact between the bearing and the journal surface. At the same time there is no rubbing action at any operating speed or load. No rubbing action is possible because there is a complete separation. So that's it. Okay, so now next is elasto-hydrodynamic lubricated bearings. So rolling contact bearings are coming under this category. So there is a oil film thickness in this case also, but this oil film thickness is very small because even we know that we are using this inner race, outer race, ball, this is your shaft. So there is a lubricating oil being present over here. So very small amount of lubricating oil is present over there, and the contact pressures are going to be very high. Hence, to prevent the metal to metal contact, surfaces finish are to be of high quality. So this is what is the requirement of this kind of bearing. Now boundary lubricated bearings. So when the speed of the bearing is inadequate, less quantity of lubricant is delivered to the bearing. An increase in the bearing load or an increase in the lubricant temperature resulting in drop in viscosity, any one of these may prevent the formation of thick film lubrication and establish continuous metal to metal contact extensively. Often bearing operating in such situations are called boundary lubricated bearings. So this is what the first part of this module. Now in this case one more type of bearing, that is solid film lubricated bearing. So for extreme temperature operations, ordinary mineral oils are not satisfactory. A solid film lubricant such as graphite, molybdenum disulfide or their combinations which withstand high operating temperature are used. These types of lubricating bearings are common in furnace applications or trunnion bearings of liquid metal handling systems or hot drying mills, etc. So here we will stop and we'll see after this the next part of this particular unit in the second video. Thank you.